to be able to have something so significant and important to so many people in your hands, and to ultimately be able to deliver that to that group of people was just the greatest honor of my life, really. I mean, what these men have done for each other on behalf of the Pitsenbarger family and on behalf of all of us is just, it's the kind of valor you just can't measure. And so for them to put their story in my hands was a great responsibility, but it was also a great privilege, and I'm so happy that it turned out.
In your opinion, why is it so hard for someone in the Air Force to receive that kind of a medal, especially someone like Pitts, who was so deserving? He rescued at least 60 men, didn't go back, risked his own life for his fellow brothers. I don't understand that.
Well, it seems so obvious now, doesn't it? But you have to remember, we're in the middle of a war, in the heart of it, really. And there was a lot going on at that time. And recognizing one man's valor at that point in time was probably not the foremost thing on the military's mind. Also, and this is conjecture to some extent, but a lot of the guys feel that since Pitsenbarger was enlisted at the time, that a lot of the heavy-duty decorations were reserved for the officers. And he, in fact, was only the third enlisted airman to ever get the Medal of Honor. And again, in the context of the politics of that time, they put him up for the medal. It went all the way to the White House. It got kicked back down as an Air Force Cross. And then some 30 years later, all those veterans, the mud soldiers who weren't even Air Force, realized that he hadn't gotten it and went to work to make sure that his valor was ultimately recognized.
It took about 30 years, but they got it done.
They got it done, yeah.